Hello, Collective. This is the Spiritual Assassinator again. So it's weighing heavy on me to make a second video extending what you guys or how you guys may perceive spiritual gifts and to help some people who may need clarity. If you feel like that your religion plays a factor with gifts that the Most High have blessed certain people or has even blessed you, and you may be worried about if you're going to be judged some type of way, or if people are going to look at you differently, or if this is the right thing to do, or should you continue this path. So this is for my people who want to learn more about their spiritual gifts, how they should tap into it, and how to go about talking to God to align themselves to their calling, to your divine calling, which is what I call the North Node. The North Node is where you're living in your divine purpose, your divine life plan. Every one of us have a divine plan. Well, the chosen ones, I want to say something that's telling me to say that. The chosen ones have a divine plan that they must carry out. I call these people the stars. That's why you see certain people, you know, who can sing, act, rap, poetry, tarot, whatever you could think of. These are many different talents that people possess because spirit creator has gave these people these gifts to teach the masses, to reach the masses, and to heal the masses. So whatever taboo that you was brought up, don't listen to what people saying. Don't listen to man. Listen to the inner man within you, the voice, the creator that's in you, because the creator is talking to you because you are a creator. You're made in God's image. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into these messages. 212, as I said, that you may want to look up that angel number. So I will be reading from Reiki. My Reiki book is called Reiki Healing for Beginners, Unlocking the Secrets of Aura Cleansing and Reiki Self-Healing, Learning Reiki Symbols and Acquiring Tips for Reiki Meditation and Reiki Psychic by David Felipe. And this is how I look. So far, this book is very informative, informational. It's a lot of information that's in this book. So I want to just tap in into a couple pages to share with you guys, to give you guys a more understanding about this healing journey and about the misunderstandings that man have put on your God-given talents that you that was given to you. So, and some of us got more than one talent. So you're doing yourself a disservice and you're doing your people a disservice if you're not using your gifts, or if you know you have gifts and you choose not to use them in the correct way. So let's go. So this is page 17, and let's continue to read. As a Christian, you might seriously be a more than a little bit worried about whether or not you should even be holding this book in the first place. But if you look through the Bible for guidance, you're going to discover you're getting worked up over nothing, my friend. See, even Jesus made use of Reiki a lot. How do you think he performed his healing miracles? Off the top of my head, I can think of several instances where he made use of Reiki. Jesus used contact to heal a wealthy man's relative of a fever, Matthew 8:14-15. Jesus used his hands to fix up a man with infection, Luke 5:12-13. Jesus healed two blind men by just touching their eyes, Matthew 20:29-34. Chapter 20:29-34. Jesus raised the dead by laying his hands on her, Luke 8:49-55. So this is basically telling me that I'm not saying that we are Jesus, but we do have traits from Jesus, from the creator, we harness those gifts to help heal the masses. So we're following behind Christ, right? Like footsteps. Well, following behind the divine, we are divinely guided, is what I'm getting at, if you guys understand. So if you're divinely guided by a source, by the ascended masters, then why not be a part of what they did when they was on earth? That's what they want you to do. You know what I'm saying? They want you to learn their techniques so you can teach it and heal others. You know, they want you to share your gifts, share your powers. How selfish would you, are you to keep your powers to yourself? What's wrong with you? To the ones who are holding their powers back and scared of how society looks at them or views them. Who cares what society says and feels? Because if you're working for spirit, for the Most High, then you're going to be fulfilled in all ways in your life. You're going to be filled in love, joy, happiness, abundance. Both physically and material. So it's on you. You can even capitalize off your gifts by helping other people. Come on, man. Like, wake up already. I'd rather be working within my gifts than working on a 9-to-5. I'd rather be helping the people out here. You know what I'm saying? That's why what I'm working on now is to build my business up, start this foundation off, because I'm not planning on being at that 9-to-5 too much longer, because I have a calling over my life and this is where I'm going to, and it's nothing's going to stop me back. I'm on a 808 train right now. I got dang going full force and ain't nothing going to stop that because it's all the way up. Now, let's continue to read. Besides, sacred writing obviously states it is okay for a Christian to be a healer. Christians who have a strong faith in God believe that God will surely direct them. Why not you too? I just said that, right? Look how these intuitive thoughts and this book is working hand in hand. So let's continue. Similarities between Reiki and Christianity. I frequently come across Christians who are not ready to accept or practice Reiki on the grounds that they feel it is conflicting with Christianity and the lessons of Christ. As I mentioned earlier, Reiki does not work based on a belief system. If you believe in Reiki or not, it will work if it is done right. Reiki isn't subject to religion at all. I can force you to accept Reiki, but I can show you different ways in which Reiki is in line with Christianity. And there are some bullet points that I'm going to share with you guys. It says, Jesus was a healer. This is acknowledged by every Christian that I know. There are a large number of occurrences in the Bible of Jesus healing people in body, mind, and soul. Jesus said that all who gained from him would do things he did, and that's just the beginning. Jesus himself mentioned that those who believed in him would do even greater things than he did, and he happened to heal people, so of course you can too. I just said this! Boy, that intuition be on it! Let's go. But let me continue to read. I love it. When you are working within your divinity and your power, everything just come to you like butter. Like just smooth and eloquently. It's beautiful, y'all. I'm trying to tell y'all, this spirituality thing is it for me. This is the best high I've ever had. Seriously. But anyway, let's get back to the messages. Jesus instructed others to heal. Jesus Christ wasn't some selfish superhero who kept his secrets to himself. He showed the majority of his devotees how to heal others and themselves. And frequently, he would support their endeavors and correct them so they could go forth and heal others properly. Come on, man. These are traits. Listen. This is what we're supposed to be doing. So to my people who are spiritualists out here, or who are people who are into their talents, even if you're not spiritual or Christian, or you can just be just somebody that's just, you know, you came across this video and you may got some type of gifts and you may be skeptical of using those gifts. Let me tell you this, use them. I promise you, it's beautiful. It's life fulfillment. It's emotional fulfillment. It's balance. It's everything that you're looking for. Like, it completes you. You know what I'm saying? That's my personal experience. So let's continue to read. All right. Jesus was caring. Jesus showed love and sympathy. Most importantly, he asked that we as a whole love and help our neighbors, which he said is anybody and everybody. It appears he wanted everyone to get healing and love. He healed his believers just as the individuals who were of different societies and religions. Healing is not for a particular religion. Thank you. The early Christians appeared to understand that the art of healing was open to all. The pieces of the new information that occurred after the passing of Jesus have numerous occasions of healing, miracles done by Christ's disciples. Paul specifically visited healers and showed different devotees how to heal as well. The main point of following the teachings of Christ is to gain some kind of knowledge and live by them. Healing is doing just that. Reiki healing is directly from God, the Creator. This energy is from the kingdom of heaven. Boy, I feel that energy coming through me, God. Help me. Let me get that Holy Spirit. Yes. Yes. This energy is from the kingdom of heaven, which is within you. Why wouldn't you want to express it? You see, Jesus has taught his followers how to generate and direct this energy for the good. Reiki is energy from God. Most see this energy as the essence of a higher power. It is very spiritual. It is a very spiritual practice and has helped a lot of Christians draw closer to God, to the Creator of the universe. What a beautiful gift that God has gave us. What a such a phenomenal experience for the ones who have abilities to accept the calling on their life. I say go for it. Continue to thrive, inspire, motivate, and lift up the masses as Jesus told us to. As the Creator told us to. It is our due diligence to come out here and do what's right and heal not only you, but the masses that's around here. Like clockwork. Let's go. Let's tap in, y'all. Thank y'all for visiting my page, The Spiritual Assassinator. If you guys need a reading, you can book with me at creativeilluminations.net. You can message me on Facebook at Starseed, and you can reach me on Instagram under Starseed as well, and you can reach me on TikTok at Starseed. I think it's 36. I'll put it in the description if that's not it, but I just started my TikTok mini read videos, so you guys may benefit from that too. Yes, TikTok Starseed 36. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in and receiving these blessings of lessons. So let's go as we continue to uplift one another. Peace be. Mwah. Namaste. Amen. Ashe.